Let us not dawdle, for there are grudges to settle, and new entries in the Damascron to write!
Howdy, howdy, Sue Devil here, and welcome to another training match with the Dwarfs versus the Wood Elves against my coach, Orokoboss, and you can see here the mighty Flame Cannon. And this is another match that that Orokoboss actually used to like in Game 1 as the Wood Elves. And I said, well, the Wood Elves really struggled against the Dwarfs, and he hadn't played this matchup, but he said, well, he wanted to bring his Wood Elves against my Dwarfs. Again, I didn't know what he was going to bring. He didn't know what I was going to bring. And this game is the result. So I'll go over my Dwarf list. You know, honestly, I think the Wood Elves are really struggling against the Dwarfs. But the list that I have here is one of the only lists where you can really can bring the Flame Cannon. And that's sort of the centerpiece of this build. It's so strong against Way Watchers or anything, you know, like that comes anywhere close to it. It has 230 range, and they just don't really have anything that can outrange it. You know, they do have magic, but that's a different thing. But Flame Cannon is absolutely awesome. I have five Dwarf Warriors. One, and I have them sort of way out front. So one, two, three, and then four, five. And I have three Longbeards, just basic Longbeards. You don't really need any armor piercing in this matchup. And then I have five Rangers. And the Rangers are good because they counter skirmish with Wood Elf missiles just fine. You know, they have shields. They don't have a whole lot of armor, but it doesn't really matter. They're not generally going to be targeted, but if they are, they're okay. And they're really cheap, and he can't see them till he gets closer, and they can get out of his visibility again. And for my range department, obviously I have the Flame Cannon, but I also have two Bolt Throwers. And those two Bolt Throwers are just to keep his leadership away, anything like dragons and stuff like that. They are anti-large armor piercing. They do have 340 range, so they give a little bit more. You could use cannons, but cannons are a lot more expensive. These are a lot cheaper. They do this essentially the same job because they don't have a lot of range. And with my leadership contingent, I do have this Rune Lord. Now, I have the Rune Lord on his mount, and the reason I do that is because I get this extra 15% magic resistance map wide, and the Wood Elves have a ton of units that do magic damage, so it's good protection. I also have the Master Rune of Grungni, so that 20% missile resistance is going to matter. It's always going to matter against them. They're going to try and snipe your Lord or snipe something. They're always going to try and get in there. You know, it's very rare. I don't know, maybe there are some rush builds that they can bring that are all infantry, but I think they're going to struggle against the Dowie, because Dowie infantry is so good, but maybe they won't, I don't know. And then I have the Runesmith, and with the Runesmith, I just have the Hammer of Karak draws in case he gets something big in, like a dragon. We do have the Rune of Wrath and Rune to slow things down, and I do have the Master Rune of Groth, one eye for the +8 leadership in this group to keep everything here functioning. So, for Orokoboss's army, he has two Way Watchers, one on this side and one on the other. And Way Watchers are really, really powerful because they have a massive range at 190 and massive missile damage at 230, but they only have 15 armor, so they are super vulnerable to fire, to flames. He has two Wild Riders. Now, Wild Riders are also awesome, but they have no armor. You know, they do have some physical resistance, what, 20%, and I think he has another one way back here. For his infantry, he does have two War Dancers. Again, same thing as always. They're really vulnerable to Dowie missiles and Dowie infantry. They are anti-infantry, but they aren't armor-piercing. For his main line, he has five Eternal Guard. They are anti-large. They do have armor-piercing, but they don't. He did not bring the shielded variant. Now, for his leadership contingent, he does have a Glade Lord. Now, this Glade Lord on the Eagle has 190 range, but he does have magical ammunition. He does have the Prey of Anathrema, which is minus 22% missile resistance and can't move, which is good. Three uses of that. And he has the Arrows of Karnos. Three uses, armor piercing, 600 meters. That's how far you can shoot those damn things. It's absolutely crazy. He has a Spellslinger of Slinger of Life. And, you know, she is just, I want to say, sort of on the ground. I don't really know she on a mount, but she doesn't know. Whatever it is, she just has one spell, and that's it. And that is, I mean, she has a Power Stone for the Magic and Earthblood for the heals. And he does have some Hawk Riders. Obviously, to get in there at a key moment, they are armor-piercing. That's really what he wants them for, not their ammunition, I'm sure. They only have 140 range, and they're not armor-piercing. And he has this guy, Waystalker. This guy's annoying. But his armor, his missile attacks are magical. But he has 190 range. He has snipe, so he doesn't get... He has snipe and stalk and vanguard. And he can fire while moving. And he has arrows of Colonel, 600 meters. So this is crazy. So we're going to get this going. And, you know, like, I guess the old way to do this was just to come in with your Way Watchers and get a shot and then get out of the way. So you're going to see he's going to come in, and these guys don't have snipe, but he's going to come in, he's going to try and take a shot at something, and without being, and then get away without getting hit by much. Now, this is the problem. Way Watchers, they're going to get their shot. He wants to come in and get a shot on my artillery. Right? So he's almost all actually in range here. He's only got 190 range, so he has to get very close. And that's the beauty of putting these guys a little bit out front, because he has to get pretty close to get his shots off, and then he's going to be in range of my other stuff. So I see this guy's in range. I'm taking some shots at him. You know, he's got 3,600 health. Now I see him, and I'm like, oh man, I gotta get going on him. So the only thing that has to hit him is the flame cannon, and I want to get shots with the Rangers. I don't know if he knows he's been seen, but I have missile resistance. Remember, he wants to get shots in here. And in come my counter shots. No, flame cannon. Boom. Beautiful. Beautiful. And I can shoot with the bolt thrower. And you can see we just take a ton of health. Now he's got these arrows of Kernos, and they're coming in, but they're magical. He's going to try and come in and get them on the flame cannons. They're magical. Apparently, they used to kill the flame cannon. So he's actually still running away. He's taking a ton of damage. Now he can heal. He's lost three models. I mean, he can put the heel on that, but he has lost three models already. And really, this is the game. This is, you know, the way that this game used to be played with the Wood Elves. And I remember playing against the Wood Elves in game one. So in came another Arrow of Colonel, so I didn't see it, and was going after this flame cannon. So I'll try and get back so you can see this game develop. And it's going to take a while, so I'm just going to hit fast forward. So you can see, I just... pushing my troops out, and he's trying to get in, get out, get in with these Way Watchers, get out. So I just want to make sure I have these bolt throwers in range, and he's going to take some shots at Dwarf Warriors with Way Watchers. I'm fine with that. I just want to get these guys in range, and you can see this guy's coming in for another shot, and you know, now I've got these guys, these Dwarf Warriors about, and my bolt throwers have just enough range to get those Way Watchers, even with these guys that far out. So again, you could use cannon, but the bolt thrower seemed to do the job just enough, right? So now, I mean, he's got to go out and come back, and I'm just trying to find that range where to put these Dwarf Warriors so that when they hit the Dwarf Warriors, I can hit them back with the bolt thrower. And, you know, I'll just fast forward it. You can see he's got another... He's trying to get a shot in here with the Glade Lord. The Glade Lord's taking no damage. Let's see. Oh, here's those arrows of Kernos again. Shooting up against my flame cannon, and he got a little bit of damage and killed one of my flame cannons, and that was quite irritating, because I still can't see him. He's just taking free shots, so I'm like, okay. So this is obviously not going to work for me, so I'm just going to push out a little bit so I can see that bugger. So he's going to try and take his free shots. I'm going to push out, and it's a pretty static game. I mean, I can't go rush out and get him. Obviously, and he can't rush in and get me, so he's just trying to whittle me down. And you know, he's really whittling down my Dwarf Warriors. My Dwarf Warriors here, and that's actually something I'm just fine with. And he's whittling down my Longbeards here. This is exactly what they're there for. They are shielded. They can take a beating, and this is sort of the ideal use for a Dwarf Warrior, is taking shots from a Way Watcher. So. He's coming in, he just keeps taking a shot on the Dwarf Warrior, and he's going to try and get those Arrows of Kernos in and get a side shot. Like, he's just trying different things. Obviously, he hasn't played this match. He hasn't even played this matchup once in Game 2. He used to play this matchup in Game 1. So he's just trying to figure out what he can do. So again, he's getting some shots in at the Dwarf Warriors, And I'm just outside of my range here. So I'm just going to push my Dwarf Warriors back a little bit and these guys up. And we'll just fast forward it because there's a little bit of, I just want to keep everybody in this buff area. The shield from the arrows, because really I know that's this outside is not my defense, right? This is not my defense. This is what defends me, right? This is just for seeing these guys. If there was a unit that was even better at seeing them, I would get that unit. So really, he's just trying to slowly encircle, get all his units in place, and I'm really catching some now. He says, okay, now it's time to come in. So I'm pulling these guys up just a little bit. I'm trying to get shots at the War Dancers. I see these Wild Riders coming in. And I'm like, okay, so I'm going to... I think these are the units to trap with the Rune and Wrath and Rune. They're going to come in and get a charge. So I get the Rune of Wrath and Rune. And I get the Master Rune of Wrath and Rune. And then I can see these Hawk Riders. You're going to try and come into the Hawk Riders and shield everything. And try and muck this stuff up. Or maybe he's going to go after these Rangers. And he's trying to get in some free shots. But he has got my Rangers. But he traded a Wild Riders. Now the Flame Cannon is going to come in. Flame Cannon is beautiful. He can just sort of unload now at this point. And I have got his Wild Riders. He did get my Rangers. I think it's a good trade for the Dawi. And, you know, he's just bringing in these guys. Try to get down right down the pipe. And these Hawk Riders are going to be in trouble now. I'm going to really start focusing on them. I'm bringing the Dwarf Warriors in here to get them the War Dancers. He's going to come in with his Glade Lord. He does use the Prey of Anathrema, which is really interesting. It's kind of an interesting play, so I can't actually come and collapse on him. But I'm going to focus everything on that Glade Lord, including my Lords. I'm just going to come in and fight and get everything shooting on that Glade Lord. Now, the Glade Lord only has 50 armor. Just doesn't have enough to do much of anything to the Dawi. We have been able to route those Hawk Riders. We got the Hammer of Karak draws. This thing has a 21 melee attack, the Glade Lord, and now finally I can come in and try and stop and pinch that great Glade Lord in. These Hawk Riders are routing. This Glade Lord is routing. And really, we've got sort of some powerful units off the battlefield already and managed to just push them off. Like, this is always going to be really extremely difficult for the Wood Elves to try and penetrate into a Dawi line, but I'm just going to obviously keep shooting to that Glade Lord, make sure that Glade Lord is dead and off the field. I did take these guys off their units, and I'll put them right back on, but obviously that's sort of the game. There's not going to be much happening from there, and Aurora Boss really just wanted to try sort of a game one style of attack on the Dawi, and I was happy to fight that type of game, really just to see how it was feeling against a player who knew what he was doing, like really, really strong Wood Elf play where he knew all the tricks. Obviously, this guy, the Waystalker, is ridiculous. Same with the Glade Lord. That Arrow of Kernos is pretty ridiculous, but because I had the missile resistance and the magic resistance, I was pretty good. But really, what I would do next time, it's funny, you learn things over time. He did get one of my flame cannons. He was able to get one. But you can see that Arrow of Kernos coming from a long ways. It's got a 600-meter range. I think you can just take your unit and take them off of their artillery, and they'll get hit with that thing. Then you put them back on the artillery, and it doesn't damage their artillery, I think. I'm gonna try that next time. This encapsulates why the dwarfs are such a hard matchup for the Wood Elves and why the game is really not fun for anyone, I think. Because, you know, the Wood Elves can't attack the Dawi and the Dawi can't run down the Wood Elves. It's sort of, there's nothing either can do in that matchup. It just is what it is. So you just go over the kills, 10-0 for the Runeslith and Rune Lord, 8-0, 22-24, 16-7. These guys are really, again, Dwarf Warriors is just there to take some shots and spot, 29-0, 22, 16 for the Longbeards. The Longbeards are awesome in this matchup. 9-1, 8-7, and 4. And he can kill these guys fast, but, there's not much he can do, really. 16-10 for the Bolt Thrower and 4 for the Flame Cannon. And you see these guys, the Waywatcher did get some kills, 20 and 36. These are very expensive units. 22 and 29 for the Wild Riders, again, very expensive. Only 5 for the Hawk Riders. And, you know, then we just were able to beat up that Glade Lord pretty easily. And, you know, the War Dancers were coming in to do some damage, but they weren't going to get a whole lot done. Anyways, would love to know what your thoughts on the matchup are, your experience with the matchup, and sort of what kind of dwarf list do you bring? I bring a Flame Cannon just because it's one of the only matchups you can safely bring a Flame Cannon. That's why. That's the only reason I bring it, because it has such short range, but there's nothing they can do about it. I mean, there probably is. I mean, if there's a Wood Elf main that has a new way of sort of taking on the Daoe in this matchup, you know, what is it? Like, how do you get into, how do you take out the Daoe when the Daoe have good artillery, especially that Flame Cannon? You saw what one shot did. You know, that Flame Cannon gets five shots in, is game over for any Wood Elf list, I think, because it's just so powerful. Five good connects, and they take out, with five good connections, they take out two units of Waywatchers for the most part, probably make them rout and get a you know, half of a Wild Rider. Like, they just do so much damage because they have no armor, right? Yeah, and as a Daoe, have you played the Wood Elves? Do you see the Wood Elves still sort of playing that style where they try and pick you apart at the edges? And if so, you know, do you play with this sort of build? I mean, this is a build I like. Dwarf Warriors are just fine. They can stand up to any infantry for a while. Any infantry they have, they can take their shots and do their spotting. They do have shields, and that's why I love them. Dwarf Warriors are awesome in this role, and this is a feature matchup for two units, the Dwarf Warriors and the Flame Cannons, and that's what makes this build function. So anyways, I would love to hear from you in the comments. I always ask for comments because that really is my favorite part of this. You know, if you play the Daoe in this matchup, what's your build look like? Is this something similar, or is this something that can help you improve your game against the Wood Elves? And if you play the Wood Elves, is this the kind of build you take? And seeing this Daoe build, does that give you ideas to make better builds for the Wood Elves? Love to hear from you down below. With that said, I hope you found it interesting, and I will see you soon.